Right, we have a great deal of mess in the garage, and one of the reasons is this shelving unit is quite magnificent, but it isn't enough, and it's become overrun, and what was actually a work area has just become cluttered with everything. So I've purchased another shelving unit, and this one will be purely for storage. It was 35 quid off eBay, so I hope it's going to be okay. And I've got the smallest car in the garage to give me most room to work. So stage one is going to have to be to clear a space here, for I think that will be the natural place for it, next to the workbench. And then I can start assembling. We are going to assume that this is not in fact a bar stool for the BMW group. We shall assume that that is fresh packaging. But if I grab some pliers, look, I actually found some tools. That's quite impressive, isn't it? Snip, 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 hopefully. Yeah, apparently these aren't the tools for the job. That's annoying. Right, knife. You will notice a subtle edit there, because as ever, my tools are all over the place, and it's really difficult to do one-handed actually, so maybe I should get my tripod. Right, dangerous new technology. I do hate this plastic strapping stuff because it's a sod to get rid of again. We get loads of it when we have our wood delivery. Oh, and it's really sharp as well. Nice to scratch me through my glove. Right, let's find out what's going on here. Bit of tape there. Bit of tape there. They didn't hold back on the sticky back plastic. Did you know that sticky back plastic apparently refers to sellotape? Other brands are available. I hadn't realised that. Right, okay, I'm starting to see something looking like metalwork. I think it's been rolled in here. Got to look at it. Or maybe they made their own box. Oh, steady now. But look, look, there's a hint of shelf there. Trying to find the best way of getting it out. Maybe it'll be to tip it. Or maybe not. Ah, I see, there's the boards. Aha! Oh, this all looks far too good for me. Oh, it's fairly thin board, so the ones on my existing bench will be better. There we go. That'll give some idea of the space I'll need. And then there's all these metal bits to try and make sense of. Corner pieces. Sections. There we are. Wonder what those are. Oh, those instructions. Yes. User manual. Heavy duty boltless shelf. Designed for hand loading only. No forklift trucks. Pity. Oh, quite like to try and justify buying a forklift truck. Right, I'm not going to film me putting this together because there are things the world simply doesn't need to see. But I shall crack on and make myself a shelf. I might also make a bit more space over there because I think I might need it actually. Yeah, now we're talking. The instructions do say that it should be assembled by two competent people. which is a bit of a shame really, because there's me. But yeah, you just push fits together. And yeah, it looks like we'll have quite a lot of shelves. So we'll have heavy stuff down the bottom, all the oils and everything that have completely taken over this area. We'll try and put those there instead. And then we'll build up with tools and other such stuff and hopefully get this space back. Of course, it does rely on me being slightly tidy, which is dangerous. Incidentally, there's my first two CVs, Sweet Pea at the bottom, B82P, and Misty Blue above. That's how the... Oh, actually, I think Misty Blue's body shell might live on. I think she was rebuilt into yet another 2CV. They've both got exactly the same chassis. Body on Sweet Pea at the bottom, rotted away. So I replaced the body, as you did in those days. Should have been a Q-plate, technically, I suppose, but there you go. Favorite badges are here. And for all my Romanian followers, Czech followers, look, favorite estate, not foreman. Well, this is looking better already. Look at the difference. Still quite a long way to go, but that's something desperately approaching organization. The other end of the garage, not so much. Give me a chance, I'm working on it. But I have found some HB12s, which are H4 bulbs with the P45T flange on for a 2CV. And I've already fitted one to the 2CV, but now we can go and fit the other one and see if that's why I haven't got both headlamps, because at the moment the one good bulb that was good is now not good. Right, so we've now got a halogen in here, which I made sure I didn't touch. More on that in a moment. And if I just set you down there, I'll set the tripod up and we'll see if we can work out what's going wrong this side. If it isn't the bulb, it's God knows what it is. Oh, there we go, it's still attached. Is that a dead halogen? Who can tell? But I mean, the bulb isn't caked in grease, but actually it's caked in all sorts of crap, which I don't think is anything to do with me at all. And the rusty flange suggests it's been in there a while. I remember fitting halogens to this 2CV. It must be at least 2004, if not earlier than that. I remember someone telling me off for not fitting relays. I finally did fit relays about 10 years later, and one of which promptly failed. So, very carefully, I will not touch the element of said bowl. I'll hold it by the prongs. I shall insert it thusly. I shall ensure you can't see anything because of my hopelessness. It's not quite lined up correctly. Let's try again. Oh, we're a very snug fit. I suppose you want, really. There we go. That's in, flip the clips in, connect the side light back up. If these wires were just ever so slightly longer, life would be dreamy. Clip on the back, peg in the bottom. Let's see what's what. There we go, dip beam, main beam. So there we go. Those of you who are saying you should replace the bulb were annoyingly right. Back to the garage. So this area still needs quite a lot of work. It's going to need a tip run to clear. I've got more tyres than I know what to do with. We've got this 2CV engine as well. And I did record bit of footage of me trying to get that running. I was hoping to be all musty one-esque and do a will it start video. It's a very old engine that's been sitting around under a tarpaulin on the front of a 2CV chassis that I acquired some time ago. I've chucked on a manifold I had sitting around But no joy. I'm not getting a fat lot of compression from it. So either the rings are not sealing, or the that's the neighbours returning, or the valves aren't seating very well. So I was going to do a video on it, but it would be a will it start video where the answer is no. So I'm not quite sure where I go next with that one. I may also have to get rid of this art. It's by a friend of mine called Richard, using it to blindfold Took at the moment. And a lovely, lovely photo of the Millennium Bridge. But one of those things, we just don't have enough space for everything. It was there. I suppose I could try and hammer a nail into these breeze blocks, but that won't be much fun. But yeah, anyway, things are starting to get better. I've got a bag of rubbish that's going to be thrown away, so I'm not going to bore you with any more details of tidying up the garage. I shall just say, yeah, I'm finally cracking on with it, which I need to, because the fox needs to undergo some work. So I shall say thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe before you go, and I shall see you in a future video. Farewell.